Today on this channel, we are talking about how to assemble a scene in Adobe Premiere Pro. But whatever that we are going to be teaching here is going to be universal because those are editing rules that you can apply regardless of which other software you are using. If this is something that you are into, then stick around. Let's figure this out. Hello and welcome to this channel. On this channel, we take the big Hollywood ideas and we transpose them into smaller ideas so that you, the indie filmmaker across any part of the world, can implement in your works. Today, we are talking about scene assemblage and how you can assemble a basic scene. Now, right off the bat, this video is targeted at beginners or people who have just gotten started in editing. So, like I said, we are going to be doing the editing in Adobe Premiere Pro, but these rules or these basic rules virtually would work in every editing software, because we are going to be sharing editing techniques and not necessarily Adobe Premiere Pro techniques. So if you are ready for this, let's dive straight into action. But before we go, guys, if you are new to this channel, kindly click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification icon so that you would get notified anytime we drop a new video on this particular platform. So guys, without much ado, thank you very much for subscribing. Let's go straight into the video. All right, so right off the bat, I have Adobe Premiere Pro running in the background already. And as you can see, we shot this scenes. There's this wide shot. This was a faulty take. We have another wide shot here. If you just do a quick scrub through. And I have proxies for this, so let me just change it to proxies so that it will be quicker. All right, so yeah. So you kind of get the idea. So we have another medium shot and we have an over the shoulder shot or OTS where we see the gentleman's face as he looks into the lady's face. All right. So the same angle, we have an extreme close up of the gentleman's face. And right after that, we have a reverse over the shoulder shot where we see the lady's face. And again, we also have an extreme close-up of the lady's face. And that is a basic coverage. Aside from that, we also have insect shots of the knife on the table. Yes. And we also have just some other cutaway shots or insect shots of the hand and as she tries to move. All right. So we have the same thing for the guy's hand. It moves slowly, it goes. Then we also have another extra angle of just the knife. So right off the bat, that's the footage that we have to work with. So I just felt like it was important we go through so that we know what we have already or what we are going to be working with. I have another video on this channel where I go in depth, especially if it's a dialogue scene, how you would go about it or how you would approach it in order to be able to get the best results out of a dialogue scene. So this one is just going to be basically how you would be able to approach a scene. So first of all, what I try to do as much as possible is once I have my rushes, which is just the raw files right from the camera, I go through them and just abreast myself once again with the script before I begin to cut. But for the purposes of this illustration, this is a non-dialogue scene. So we are going to jump straight away into cutting it. So like I said, these are the basic coverages that we have. And I have another separate video again on this channel where I teach how to shoot a scene or how to specifically shoot a dialogue scene. And it includes all these available types of coverages, or let me say it includes this kind of angles or all the angles that are here. So as you can see, fairly you can argue that we have all the necessary angles to be able to cut a better scene or to be able to cut a better video out of this. So enough of the talking, let's go straight. So the basic rules of cinema is we start wide and walk our way closer and closer to the action. So in this sense, we are going to start with a wide shot. And so what this does is that your audience get to know where the action is taking place before you start to go in closer and closer. For example, if I start a scene just on a close-up or something, you might not actually know where we are. And you know, the scene happens in the close-ups till the scene is done. nobody would actually know where the scene has just taken place, and your audience would be lost. So what happens is we start from the wide shot so that the wide shot establishes where we are so that the audience get to know where the action is taking place before you start going in closer and closer then till you get to your close-ups. All right. So that is exactly what we are going to do. So let's start with this. Let's make our first cut. All right, so let's pick this, put this on the timeline. So that is basically our first cut. So right away, let's get a little closer. So let's use a scene.
One, two.
All right, so let's add this. Okay, so already just look at what we have. We start here. We get closer, so like this. We get closer. All right. So right from here, we can now go to over the shoulder shot. So we can decide now whether we want to see the lady's face or we want to see the gentleman's face, and as to whether we want an extreme close up or not. But like I said, let's stick to the basic principles, which is we are working our way slowly and slowly closer to the characters. So in that sense, let's see the gentleman. So let's see.
One, two.
All right. So we can cut it right from here. I think let's cut it just when he blinks. All right. We cut it over there. And I'm thinking right after that, we should see the lady's face. Then after we see the lady's face, which is just this normal medium shot, what we can do is then we now cut back to the gentleman's face. And by this time, we go to the extreme close-up. All right. So let's see if that works. So let's cut to the lady. All right. So this blink. Then let's cut it from there. Let's put this on the timeline. And now let's cut back to the gentleman. Instead of cutting to this other particular shot, which is just like an over-the-shoulder shot where you can see the other lady, with this one, we are going to be going with the close-up or extreme close-up. So you would realize that we started a little bit wider and we're getting closer and closer to the action. All right, so let's see this. Just a blink. Get it from a blink.
Five.
Okay, so yeah, so right from here, I'm thinking what we can do is let's get an insert shot of the gentleman's hand moving, then we get the other counter reaction from the lady's face, which is her extreme close-up. So let's do this. Let's look for that insert shot. Okay, here. All right. So let's pray through. All right, let's make a cut from here. And we go to the extreme close-up of the lady. So again, we are not coming to this particular shot. We've already used this. So that is why I'm thinking let's go with this particular one. So it will make sense to have the lady's eyes come from down so that probably it could mean she is looking at what is going on down there. So let's start.
One, two.
All right. So we cut from there. And I think from there too, let's see this. Let's see what they are looking at. And all right. So let's make an in point. Okay. We don't let it delay too much. Okay, just a little bit. Let's trim it down. And so right after this particular one, I'm thinking before we get back to anyone's face, let's see the lady's hand too moving slowly so that it makes sense from this point, because we've seen this just lying down. So, all right. Okay, so we can cut it from here. Okay. So I'm thinking we can get back to the lady's face again with the extreme close up. All right. So let's make an in point here. All right. Let's make an out point. Let's drag this to the timeline. Let's make a quick save. And I'm thinking that we can still maintain extreme close-ups because we walked our way from far and we got closer and closer. So at this point, we could draw ourselves back again, but I'm just thinking that it's only nice that we stick to the extreme close-ups. Then again, it's because of the type of action that is going on here, because we are as much as possible trying to conceal what is going on so that the audience don't really understand this scene. And that is actually the intention. All right, so let's see.
Two.
All right, so the gentleman raises his head.
What's up? One, two.
All right, so I'm thinking from here, probably let's cut back to the medium shot so that we see just before the both pick. All right, so we can make an in point here. Okay, so just before the hand impacts, I'm thinking it's a little bit short, so let's add a little bit from here. So in point, we put it here. So let's get back to the close-up of this, and let's play through just when the hand, so like this. Good. Yes. So let's make it from here. Go back frame by frame. Yes. All right. So let's add this. Okay. So basically, let me just take off all these audios. All right. And let me open this up so that we can get to see what we've just done. Basically, those are the basic rules you can follow in order to be able to assemble a scene. So let's go through it again. So this is our wide shot, which we started with. Then we jumped straight to a medium shot. Then we came to an over the shoulder shot. We jumped into the reverse angle over the shoulder shot of the lady. We came back again with an extreme close up of the guy's face. We cut to an insect shot of just his hand moving. We cut to the lady's face to establish that the lady has seen what is going on. Then we cut to what they are all looking at a particular time. All right. So at this point, the audience now see clearly what these guys are all looking at. So right from there, we cut to the lady's hand. So now we are establishing that this is what they are all trying to take. All right. So right from there, we cut back to the lady's face. Then we went back to the gentleman. Just when he was looking down, he raises up his head. Then we see all of them looking at each other. The hand move, and just when they're about to hit, then we cut over. All right, so let's have just a quick playthrough. Let me press the Attila key to open this up. Let's make a quick play. All right, so yes, basically that is what we have been able to create. So as you can see, it isn't really that difficult. So once you have quality pictures or once you have quality angles to work with, this isn't really a problem for you at all. And again, even if they brought you not the best of quality of footage, you can still be able to make something out of it. So like always, I encourage you to keep practicing because that is the only way you can get to master this art. In this illustration, we just used Premiere Pro to do this cut, but this is editing based and not necessarily the editing software based, or we are not talking about Adobe Premiere Pro here. So just learn this concept and you can use any editing software at all and still achieve the same result. So basically, always remember that we start from wide and we walk our way closer and closer. But as always, this is art and there are exceptions to this particular rule. There are certain instances we have something we call from the ambiguity to the known. So if we were using this particular approach, so what we could have done is to rather start the scene on a close-up. For example, we could decide to begin the scene with this. And what will happen is that, so when the scene starts, people are just going to see a knife just lying on the particular bench, and nobody knows what this knife is for or where it's coming from or where it's going to. And so all this adds to spice up the story and makes it very lovely and makes the scene much more suspenseful, because the audience have just come into this particular scene and they really don't know what is going on, or they really don't know what to expect. So that is a very nice way to hook your audience, because once you start on a close-up of something, or you start on something that they don't know of, then they are confused and they really don't know what is happening. So they have to stick around, they have to keep watching till the scene gets to the middle, or when the scene starts to take off, before they would understand. But what I would say is, don't drag this too much. But if you learn how to use this very well to your advantage too, trust me, you are going to up the quality of your films. So guys, that is basically it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed yourself and you learned a lot. If you are new to this channel, guys, kindly click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification icon so that you get notified anytime we drop a new video on this particular platform. If you have any further questions, guys, you can leave them in the comment section below, or you can DM me on Instagram at @OBL_Junior, and I will gladly respond to all your messages. This episode was kindly supported by Pave Ghana. And like we do it here, guys, like always, keep practicing filmmaking. Peace out.